Hi there. We're here today to talk about the Ontario Beekeepers Association's Tech Transfer Program. I'm here with my supervisor, Dr. Ernesto Guzman, and my colleague, Les Eccles. Les is the lead of the Tech Transfer Program. I'd just like to talk a little bit about the history of the program. Back in the 90s, we were most of our research here at the University of Guelph was with tracheal mites. They were a significant new problem, and so we started breeding for resistance to tracheal mites. That became so popular within the beekeeping community that the Ontario Beekeepers Association set up what they called the Tech Transfer Program to continue this breeding work and to continue with some very applied education and research. So that program's been running ever since. It's been used as a model for programs throughout North America, and we found it's really worked out very well to be able to get the information we're working on directly in the hands of the beekeepers. And Ernesto is going to talk a little bit about the collaboration that we have with the Tech Transfer Program and how that benefits both of us.
Hi, I'm Ernesto Guzman. I want to highlight the importance of the collaboration between the Tech Transfer Program and the Honeybee Research Center. It has been fundamental from several standpoints, from the research standpoint, from the beekeeping education standpoint. We have conducted a number of studies and workshops together that have been very successful. One example of that is when we studied the different causes that result in colony collapse during winter, and because of that collaboration that involved hundreds of colonies and assessments of different types in the lab resulted in the knowledge that more than 85% of the fatality cases of colonies in Ontario are due to the varroa mite, which led to another collaboration. Studies on different products used to control the varroa mite. Most of these products are organic products that don't compromise the health of the bees and are safe for high products. And we have another group of studies that have been conducted, including the current one on breeding for low varroa growth, which is intended to develop strains of honeybees resistant to the varroa mite. And we could number many more studies that we have successfully conducted together. And this collaboration is based on the fact that many of the technicians that have worked and worked today at the Tech Transfer Program were trained here at the Honeybee Research Center, and then they moved to the Tech Transfer Program. So, to conclude, basically, this collaboration has been very successful and beneficial to science, to beekeeping education, and hopefully to the beekeeping industry of Ontario.
Thanks, Ernesto. Yeah, I like to refer to us as the farm team for the big leagues working with the Tech Transfer Program. We get some great people right in off the street here. Les showed up as a volunteer, and now he's industry leader and a queen breeder in his own right, and so it's really great that we're able to nurture these people and see the success that they have in directly communicating with beekeepers. So Les is going to talk about the breeding work that the Tech Transfer Program is doing. Les.
Hey, thanks, Paul. Like Ernesto and Paul mentioned, the collaboration between the Honeybee Research Center at the University of Guelph and the OBA Tech Transfer Program is essential. The work that Tech Transfer does is basically divided into two parts, extension and education. So training beekeepers on best management practices, current recommendations, and just keeping them up to date on how they can keep their honeybees healthy and productive. And then the second part is research. But specifically field-applied research. So where the Tech Transfer Program comes in is when there's promising research done at important institutions like the University of Guelph that can be applied to the beekeeping industry, the tech transfer program becomes involved to get it into the field and show that it's field realistic and successful and reasonable to apply into an operation. So it's just this natural match that really doesn't exist in a lot of areas, and it's a huge benefit to the Ontario beekeeping industry, and that spreads really well outside of the province and the country. So it's a really important relationship that we have. The tech transfer program, it really did start with a concept that was based on how to keep honeybees healthy previous to varroa mites and the impact it had on the industry. Beekeeping was relatively simple as far as keeping healthy honeybees. The beekeeping manuals were about this thick and about this big. It talked mostly about American foulbrood. Varroa mites completely changed that, as did trachea mite when it first came in. And that's really what started the work on creating more information on honeybee health through treatments and through breeding. So we work with the University of Guelph on both those aspects when it comes to research and applied field research. Today what we're talking mostly about is the breeding part of beekeeping. And that's really, I think it's important to divide two aspects of breeding and queen rearing. So one is rearing queens, raising queens, and the other is breeding bees. We often say queen breeding, but we're actually breeding for honeybees and the workers and all their characteristics. You can't become a queen breeder until you're a good queen rear. So those are two very different things. If you're interested in queen breeding, you need to get well trained on queen rearing first. The tech transfer program has workshops on queen rearing, manuals on queen rearing that you can find on the OBA website. But that's by far the first part before you even consider getting into selection and breeding for honeybees. Ontario has a breeding program called the Ontario Resistant Honeybee Selections Program, or ORHBS for short. It really started back in the early 90s for breeding for resistance to trachea mite. That was very, very successful to the point where we don't find trachea mites in our honeybee local stock anymore in our breeding program. We still check and all our stock with our breeders to make sure it's not coming back, but we haven't found trachea mite in Ontario stock for at least 15 years now. We also select for resistance to Nosema, chalkbrood, American foulbrood, mostly through selection for something called hygienic behavior. So the bee's ability to identify sick or infected brood and clean that out before that disease can spread to a point of no return in a colony. That's been a very successful program. The tech transfer program supplies the hygienic testing services to the breeders in the ORHBS program. And along with that, we, as mentioned in previous videos, this kind of linked this one, is the new research into low varroa growth. And as far as I know, we are the first breeding program to integrate that formally into a breeding program for breeders. Something called low varroa growth in colonies, so direct resistance to varroa mite resistance. So it's a very exciting time in the breeding program to be doing that, because varroa mites is the number one colony health aspect that we need to control. And so bringing that into resistance and breeding is complementary to the other work we do with treatments. In order to keep our treatments working, we can't be totally dependent on them. We also need a genetic aspect, so the bees have resistance, supply some of that resistance to varroa that goes along with the treatments that we're using. We need both to work together. Besides, so there's kind of two parts to breeding there that we kind of consider important as far as what we're looking for in honeybees. So I mentioned the breeding for resistance to different diseases and pests. The other part is kind of the more enjoyable part of beekeeping, the nice things that we like to work about with bees. So low defensive behavior is really important. Some people may think that's not, if you put gloves up and suit up, that's all you need to worry about low defensive behavior. But when you think about having bees in the public, and frankly, when you're working bees, the calmer your bees are there, the better your work is. You're more efficient working, whether it's making splits, moving bees, if those bees are calm with whatever your work you're doing in that hive. So it's not a purely enjoyable aspect. It's actually for the work efficiency in the yard as well. Other things include low swarming, comb stability, and just longevity of queens. So we actually, in our breeding program, we have a list, a fairly extensive list of characteristics that we breed for. What's important to know about the ORHBS program, and like what we like to reiterate, is we're not saying our program's the best or the only way to breed honeybees, but what we've outlined with our program of breeders is well defined. So when we work with our various breeders, which we have about 25 breeders in the province, when we talk about defensive behavior, we all know what defensive behavior means for our program. If we're talking about low swarming, we have the same definition for low swarming. So every characteristic that we're talking about in a program is well defined and is graded in a defined 5-point system. And that was what was important in formalizing our program, because there's lots of ways to evaluate, grade bees, and there can be very passionate discussions about what the best way is, but what we wanted to do was to be on the same page and work together as breeders. So that, I think, is one of the most important things about the ORHBS program, is that it's a collaborative program amongst breeders in our industry that allows us to communicate, select on a consistent level, and keep a very large pool of genetics that we can work together on the same page. One of the biggest challenges with breeding is having a large enough pool to select from. Individual breeders can only manage so many breeder colonies, but when you pool them together, you actually end up with a large pool of in a consistent breeding program that can be used between breeders. So that's why we breed for honeybees, is to really to benefit the industry as a whole. Obviously, there's a profit to be made when you sell queens and that, but the amount of work that goes into breeding isn't nearly offset by sales. It really is something breeders are passionate about and think are important and add value to the industry. So that's why and what we do for breeding. You'll see in this video a selection process. So we use an evaluation process to weigh the criteria, and that's part of the ORHBS program. So that's, I think, another important part. When you're trying to integrate many characteristics into your program, you need an organized way of doing that. So that's another important aspect of our breeding program.
Well, Les, that's a really great overview. Tough to capture it all in a short little video here. So what I would suggest you do is go to the Ontario Beekeepers Association website and have a look through that website. There's all kinds of information on the ORHBS program and on the courses that the Tech Transfer program offer as well, both for bee breeding, but just beekeeping, general beekeeping as well. Lots of great information there. So thanks very much, Les, and thank you for watching.